Product campaigns and political campaigns have a lot in common. They both lead people toward a decision. There's a well-known LA manager and lawyer, his name's Larry Thompson. He caught my attention a while back when he was talking about a survey regarding decision-making. Just like waves, as they move towards a shore, they're made up of different parts. Whether you're buying a product or considering what candidate we're going to vote for, we're first drawn in by the appearance, by the bling, the demeanor of our object of interest. Is it the latest and greatest? Have they made the mistake of the day? The big oops from our candidate or the opponent? Is it an issue that comes just as the news of the day? That is a fad. It comes, it goes. It's ephemeral, like the froth at the top of the wave. As things move along, we start paying attention to things like polls, talking heads, reviews of the product, reviews of our peers of people. People who are making attempts at working through our problems with a genuine effort. We pay attention to the creation of a return to maybe a genre in entertainment or politics that catches our fancy. Those are trends. And just like a set of waves moving toward the shore, they move at a fairly constant rate. But folks, when it comes time to reach for a credit card or to pull the curtain closed behind us in a voting booth, almost always it's shown, we vote with the driving force of our lives, the true hidden force that drives those waves like we do. It's a constant force. For us, that's our values. They are, or at least should be, a constant. Now, we make decisions every day based on fads, trends, and values, how we interact with each other, how we buy things, the clothing we wear for ourselves or to fit in with the crowd, or how we respond to the drunk at a cocktail party. It's usually reflecting what's going on with our lives and what view we're taking. Hopefully, we skew towards the long view rather than the fad. Sometimes it's just hard to be a grown-up. I'm Ron Jackson.